मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, हाउ आर यू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स? यस्टरडे वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्योर सब्सटेंसेस, एलिमेंट्स, कंपाउंड्स, एंड आई हैड टोल्ड यू दैट दोज सब्सटेंसेस विच आर मेड अप ऑफ ओनली वन काइंड ऑफ एटम, वेदर द नंबर ऑफ एटम इज वन और मोर बट इट इज ऑफ सेम काइंड, ओके, देन इट इज नोन एज एलिमेंट. क्लियर? Like oxygen is an element because while combining two oxygen atoms, one O and one O are combining together forming oxygen molecule. Okay. Similarly, only one helium atom is representing itself. Okay. It is a monoatomic substance and oxygen is a diatomic. Okay. Now students, compounds. Yes, compounds, when we are mixing one or more elements together, okay, in a fixed proportion, like if I am adding two molecules of one element and two molecules of one element, then it is a compound. But if I don't know the number of atoms of a particular element, then that is an impure substance. Okay, now today we will study about the impure substance. Okay, because impure substances are made up of by combining two or more elements together, but we don't know the ratio, quantity of those elements. Okay, whether they are two in number, whether they are three in number, but we don't know the exact amount, that how much we are mixing them. Okay, so let's begin with the impure substances, that is known as mixtures. See, when two or more elements or compounds mix together, not necessarily in a definite ratio, then the resulting substance is called as mixture. As we all know that air is pure or the polluting, but do you know that whether it is a pure air or the impure air, we don't know the proper composition of the air which is available to us. Like if we start comparing about my air and your air, see, we both are surviving in the atmosphere and atmosphere is filled with air, but the composition of air is different at different places. It is very difficult to identify that how much nitrogen is available in the air which is present near me, or the oxygen or the carbon dioxide. Okay, similarly with you all, but if we are having a glass of distilled water, means the purest water. Okay, distilled water means the water which does not contain any type of mineral. It is only hydrogen and oxygen. One glass you have and one glass I have. We both are having one glass of distilled water. Means the level, the quantity of the molecules, the atoms which is present in the water is same, whether you have or whether I have. That is known as compound. Okay students, both the glasses will have two hydrogen atom and one oxygen atom and combining together forming distilled water. Okay students, now I think mixture and the compound is clear to you all. Now move towards the types of mixture. See, here are the types of mixture: heterogeneous mixture and homogeneous mixture. See, in both the diagrams we have the balls of two colors. One is purple and the other one is sea green. See, in this diagram the balls are arranged with some similarity, with some sequence, like one color of sea green and the other color of purple and vice versa repeating. But in this mixture the balls are not arranged properly. Okay students, now let me tell you the definition of homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture.
See students, when we are mixing two substances of unknown quantity, okay, but they are mixing properly, means equally. Like if you are making some sugar syrup, means you are dissolving sugar in a glass of water, then are you able to identify that this part of water contains more sugar and this part contains less? No, because the sugar will get equally distributed in all the water. Although at the bottom some undissolved sugar particles are lying over there, and if you are drinking that undissolved particle, naturally they will give more sweet taste, but it is not considered as an example of homogeneous mixture because that particles are not dissolving anymore in the solution. Later on you will study about that. First of all, just understand that if we are making a nimbu pani, okay, it means the lemon will spread equally. It doesn't mean that if you are having the one cup of juice from the jug and we both are having the same taste, means the lemon is equally distributed everywhere. Even the sugar will get equally distributed in the jug. Okay students, that's why we both are having the same taste. Okay, but if you are dissolving the chalk powder in the water, what will happen? The chalk powder will get settled at the bottom, and the water, you will get the pure water at the top, and at the bottom you will get some impure water because that water contains soil particles. Okay students, as you have observed while drinking the water from some pitcher means mud pot, in that the soil particles are lying at the bottom, and the water, you will get the pure form of water at the top. Means if you are drinking water without shaking the pot, the soil particles will get undisturbed and you are drinking the pure water. But when the level of the water will get decreased and the water and the soil particles are getting disturbed, in that situation the water, you will get the impure water. Okay students, means whatever the impurities are not distributed equally, they all are settling at the bottom. Okay students, such type of mixtures in which the particles are settling at the bottom, are depositing at one place, such type of mixtures are known as heterogeneous mixture. And homogeneous mixture, when all the substances are equally distributed. Now the question for you to think, I will give the answer for this tomorrow. Blood is a homogeneous mixture or a heterogeneous mixture? Just think about it. Okay students, tomorrow we will discuss about it. No need to ask the answer today and to anyone. Just think by your own. Now move forward in the topic that, do you know how many elements are there in our surroundings? Or we can say on the earth, not in our surroundings only. Yes, there are 117 elements available on the earth. Okay students, 117 elements. Okay, you people are familiar with few only. Gold, silver, platinum. Yes, aluminium, iron. Okay, but there are 117 elements related to all these things and are available on the earth. And these elements are reacting with each other and forming different type of compounds. Okay? Okay students? Now one more thing, just think about it. There are 117 elements. We have to learn them. And for this, we have to make certain arrangements. As I told you about the atomic number, that each element is having one atomic number. Like you people are having one roll number, and you can represent by yourself. See, if a school is collecting the school diary for checking the homework, and someone is asking to you that roll number 5 will submit the diary, you will easily understand that who have to submit the school diary today? Isn't it? It means roll number is very important in your life to represent yourself in a school. Similarly, students, these elements are having a particular roll number, and their roll number is known as atomic number, okay, to which they are representing by themselves. See, if I said that I want to react an element having atomic number 5, then those who know the number, the element which is available on this number, they can easily understand. That's why it is very important to learn the atomic number of some elements. Okay? Later on, side by side, one day you will be able to answer the atomic number of all the 117 elements, but not today. Okay? In this class, in 7th class, you will learn only the atomic number of at least 1 to 20 atomic elements. Okay, students? Now, move forward. Before learning the elements, you have to understand one more thing. See, these all elements are represented by some short notations. And these notations are known as symbols. Symbols, the smallest symbols which you have observed in your daily life is the traffic symbols, that where you have to go fast, where you have to drive slow, where the barriers are coming. Such type of symbols you are using, you are watching regularly. Few symbols like anger, like a smile, which are representing a particular person is happy with you or not. This type of symbols which we are using for different type of situations, okay, students? But here I am going to just telling you the meaning of the word symbol. Now we are utilizing the short notations, the symbol, for all the elements which are available to us. That means all the 117 elements. See, few of the elements are represented by the first letter of their word, like oxygen, like nitrogen, carbon. They are representing by O, N, C respectively. Okay? Now, few elements are represented by the first and the second letter of their name, like bromine, Br. Few, calcium, Ca. Okay, students, are you listening properly the symbols of these elements? Now, few are represented by the first and the third letter of their name. Chlorine, C, not CH, it's Cl. Okay, similarly, magnesium, it's Mg, not Ma. Okay, first of all, let me clarify that why these elements are having these symbols. Later on, we will discuss about the fourth bullet point, letter name. Okay, students, now, see, students, few, the easiest symbol are represented by the first letter. Now, if the first letter means O is occupied by someone, N is occupied by someone, now C is occupied by someone, and if the another name, another element with the same alphabet will coming, like carbon, calcium is also starts with C, and carbon is having C symbol already. It means calcium is not supposed to take that C, because it is not possible to represent two elements with the same symbol. Okay, how do we clarify if we are saying that we want C? That if anywhere C is written, how will you understand whether we are talking about carbon or calcium? So that's why, to bring the separation, to bring the proper classification, it is important that each element must have a separate symbol. That's why later on we start using first and second letter for different elements. Now the third one. If we are using first and the third letter. Now students, the problem is there while putting the symbol for these elements, we are using one property. What? The number. See, the alphabet, which is having more impact while speaking that word. We are using that particular alphabet as a symbol. See, like in chlorine, CH is not important, but sound of L is dominating the sound of H. That's why Cl we are using as a symbol of chlorine. Similarly, in magnesium, Mg. Okay, students? Because the sound of G is dominating over A. Okay, students? Few more examples? Yes. Tomorrow I will tell you the name of the 1 to 20 elements with their atomic number and their symbol. Okay, students? Now, the next one is few elements are having the symbol from their Latin name or the Greek name. See, like sodium. Sodium is an element. Potassium is an element. They are having some other name also. That is in their Latin language or Greek name. Like sodium is having natrium. Potassium is having kalium. Okay? Few more elements are there which is having their second name as a Latin or the Greek name, as they are already discovered in the ancient time when English is not popular or unknown. Okay, at that time the language was used Greek and the Latin. That's why they are having name in that languages. Okay, and their symbol is based on their Latin names or Greek names. Like sodium is having the symbol Na, which is based on its name natrium. Again, potassium is having the symbol K, which is based on its name kalium. Okay? This symbol is taken from the word kalium, the first letter of their name, kalium. Potassium is represented by kalium. Okay? Why we are not representing potassium by P? Because when kalium starts calling as potassium, and by the time some other element having the atomic number, having the symbol P is already discovered. And that symbol is phosphorus, having atomic number, having the symbol P. Phosphorus is represented by the symbol P. Okay? Tomorrow I will tell you different elements with their symbol and the atomic number. Now, your classwork, that is long question number 2. I am orally telling you the question, the title, heading of the question, that is, describe how the properties of a compound can be very different from the property of the element that make it up. Take the help of an example. Okay, students, this is long question number 2. And the answer is available over here in front of you. Write it down, this answer, in your notebook. That is the difference of elements and the compound. As the question is saying that compare the properties of elements with the compound. Yes, element is the pure chemical substance made up of same type of atom. Compound contains atom of different elements. Chemically combined together in a fixed ratio. You understand this definition properly? Why chemically combined? Because they are reacting to satisfy. They are combining together and they are the chemical compounds. Okay, students? Later on, I will tell you how these elements are combining. We will get the knowledge related to this topic when we are making the chemical formula of the compounds. Okay, students, you will understand it very better. Now, an element is represented using symbols. A compound is represented using its chemical formula, like water, H2O is a formula. And symbol like O, O2, He, N2. Okay, students, now elements can be broken down into elements cannot be broken down into simpler substances by chemical reactions. See, students, as as elements are not having a choice to get breakdown. Reason is that if they get break, they will become unsettled. They will not be stable. And unstable items will not be available. They will get exhausted, or we can say lost. Okay, to show their appearance, to be present, they have to be stable. Okay, students. Now, after that, compounds can be separated. Okay, as we can separate water, we can separate hydrogen and oxygen, and we can break the water compound. Okay, by chemical methods, by chemical reactions, that you will study in your further classes. Now, the example of elements and the example of compounds: hydrogen, oxygen, sodium, chlorine, carbon, iron, copper, silver, gold, etc. These all are the elements and compounds. Water, sodium chloride, NaCl is the name of common salt. Sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. Okay, students, sodium bicarbonate is the common name of is the chemical name of baking powder. Students, the baking powder which we are using in the baking industry is sodium bicarbonate. Okay, students, now you understand. You are getting these one word questions, that what is the chemical name of common salt, sodium chloride, and what is the chemical name of baking powder, sodium bicarbonate. Okay, students.
So, students, now I want to clarify one thing, that you will get homework in science only on Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Okay, by the time just do your classwork only, and whatever we are doing right now, just read it through the book. And yes, of course, if you are not having book, read the chapter from those clicks which I have sent it on the group. Okay, students. Thank you, everyone.